on the line, live, up close and personal, Keith Orlando Harris. How you doing, man?
Hey, how you doing today? You said you were talking about it. I'm hoping it's good then. Hey, I didn't hear. You got to tell me.
Well, let me tell you. We were talking about this girl because she's an Instagram model. So...
I'm wondering if I'm going to be known for the rest of my life as the Instagram model guy now because of this song.
Oh my God, man, that is such a great song. It is rare when we have a song, when we play it the first time, somebody calls up and be like, who is that, Bob? What was the name of that song again?
Oh my God. Well, I gotta be honest with you. For me, like, that's my first music video. But not only that, this is my first time on the radio. So you're hitting two firsts for me.
Oh my God.
I'm appreciative.
Wow. Well, you know what? Let's go ahead and get into it because you have so many people that are definitely interested in Keith Orlando Harris, Keith O. Harris. And how did you get started in the music? Let's start taking all the way back in the beginning. Did you get started with your family? Did you get started at an early age?
Actually, I'll be honest with you. I'm kind of new when it comes to singing. I used to sing in choir when I was a kid. And it was like, it wasn't even that long. I used to sing, oh my God, I remember my mom hearing me singing at the top of my lungs, you know, for like an hour a day, and my mom would close the door to her room, like, what is this kid doing? I just love singing. I used to listen to a lot of R&B, Drew Hill and Jodeci, and just I just loved R&B. Mm-hmm. And so I never would have imagined when I was a kid that I could end up making my own music video. But I ended up getting into filmmaking later on and studying comedy and writing comedy. And then just when I ended up in Kazakhstan, which I don't know if we can get into that, but I ended up traveling the world. And then throughout the pandemic, when the pandemic started, I got stuck in the country of Kazakhstan. So while I was there, I was like, well, I want to be able to do something, with my filmmaking, and I started making some comedy videos. And then kind of as a goof, I was like, let me see if I can go ahead and like make a music video. I never in a million years would have thought that the result, she's an Instagram model, would have came from basically being on lockdown in another country and, having to figure out, you know, how do I do something with my comedy skills? How do I do something with my filmmaking skills? And then, you know, taking on that challenge, I surprised myself.
Well, you have done an excellent job. And looking at your resume and your bio and all this stuff that you've done, first of all, you traveled, you're internationally known to rock the microphone. And
I love that. I'm gonna use that.
Oh yeah, definitely need to use that. I was amazed because you come really kind of like from a film background, so you've made a lot of films, right?
Oh yeah, well, a lot of short films. So I haven't made anything big that you've, you're not going to see me on big time TV. hopefully, maybe with this song. But I made some short films that ended up getting a bunch of awards. So if you look up my name, Keith Orlando Harris, on IMDb, you'll see about 20 awards for different films that I've done. And I lived in China, I've lived in Japan, I've traveled to like 34 countries. So when I was always traveling, I would take my camera with me everywhere, and it just kind of became a thing where I was like, let me see if I can make a short film, I'll make some kind of movie, I'll make comedy. And also, living in these countries, I ended up studying a lot of languages. So I studied Chinese, studied Japanese, and I would try to, again, as a group, like, let me see if I can do some videos in this language, and then I'd do it in English, I'd do it in another language. I've been basically traveling around like a child, I feel like. Having the time of my life. But because of that experience, it helped me grow. And I think if it wasn't for all of that experience, I wouldn't have been able to do something, you know, like promote being on all these different places and learning from all these cultures. I wouldn't have been able to do something like this music video if it wasn't for all of that.
You know, you talk about the music video, but even just your general life, most people would love to do what you're doing because you could tell that you're well-cultured. You've had several, you know, different experiences. You're living a dream that most people would love to live.
Yeah, well, it's an expensive dream, unfortunately. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. I don't know if my wallet will agree with you, but I will say it's I remember one time I started talking to this young black kid, and I'm half black, half Puerto Rican. Mm-hmm. I told him about my life, and he had said to me, I don't know if I have anyone in my family who's ever traveled that much or who's ever, you know, seen the world like that. And I said, the moment that you're that one person who does that, then you set the record for what everybody like thinks about, you know, whether it's like people on the ground, the people who look like you. You show them what's possible. So I don't know how much time we have, but just
no, take your time. Take your time.
Yeah. When I was in China, I remember I started talking to this one of my students there, and she had told me, like, you know, teacher, you're one of the, because I taught English there. She said, oh, you're one of the my first foreign friends that I've ever had, and I was like, what do you mean? It's like, yeah, because you could speak Chinese, so because she could see someone that looked like me speaking in her language, and my Chinese isn't fluent, but I, you know, I practiced a lot when I was there and studied before I left. It was like this connection where she felt like she had a connection to the outside world, and it's the same everywhere you go. When I was in Kazakhstan, I think I might have been the only half black, half Puerto Rican dude there, period. I would almost bet money on it, and maybe there was like 100 foreigners in the country. So to be in a country where you don't know the language, you're trying to figure it out, and then you're like, let me just go ahead and see if I can do a music video as a group. Yeah, my life is crazy.
Well, crazy good. I mean, you are definitely setting the world on fire. How did you come up? What was the inspiration behind She's an Instagram Model?
Oh, right. Well, I actually ended up dating a girl in Kazakhstan when I was there. And this girl, we ended up moving in together. And her dream, you know, like a lot of people talk about this, their dream, I want to go to America. I was like, okay, well, yeah. America's cool, right. I get it. But she's like, she told me her dream was to become a dancer, and she wanted to, you know, go on Instagram. And you know, and she said, I want to be an Instagram model. I was like, what? And it made me laugh when she said it. And then she ended up like going, she traveled to Dubai, and then she ended up leaving Kazakhstan. But after she left, I was like, it was just such a funny statement that stuck in my head. I want to be an Instagram model. And I was like, you know, I have to do a comedy video about this. And then it was going to start out as like a 15 second little like parody. And then it became a whole music video. I didn't realize, like, for a year and a half, from the moment I thought of the idea to the moment I completed the music video, it took that long. I had to direct, write, produce, act, sing. You know, my singing was not as good as it is on that video until I practiced like every day, 3 hours a day, like a crazy person for months. So yeah, it was like the moment I decided to take on the step of, let me do that 15 second pair, and then it became this bigger thing. I knew that if I was going to give the world something that represented me, I had to do the best I could. And I think that the film festivals and all the awards and everything, thank God, has proved that. But I hope the viewers and the listeners love it as well.
Well, you know, the follow-up would be She's an OnlyFans Model. That is the sequel of She's.
You know, I was thinking about that, but I was like, you know what? Hey, I gotta slow down with that. I don't know if that's OnlyFans body. I always think it's like funny. Like that whole world, you know, that whole world is just kind of funny to me, and how men, we just go crazy over the Instagram models. I had to make a group about it. And I think, yeah, that music video, it's, every time I watch it, I laugh, and I'm like, I know I did a good job. I'm so proud of it.
You did an excellent job. And this is one of the things, there's a couple of questions I want to ask you. The next one, what, or should I say, who is the biggest artist that influenced you as far as musically? And second, what artist or filmmaker or, you know, entertainer, if you given the chance, would you like to work with or collaborate with?
Oh my God. You know what? I will say, when I was doing this music video. Like, and that's the thing also. This is a song you guys are hearing, everybody's hearing, mm-hmm. but there's a music video. Just type in to YouTube, she's an Instagram model, and you'll see the music video, and the music video is hilarious. Weird Al Yankovic, funny, it's, you know, but with R&B people. Mm-hmm. When I was singing the song, every day I was practicing the song. I had to write the lyrics and practice. I was listening to Jodeci every time. Like, I would listen to it before for My Lady, and then others. I would just listen to them before because it would help me get in that mood to, like, I got to sing this, like, soulful song, and I got to be able to put the riffs in there and full force. I would listen to Drew Hill. I would listen to Cisco, you know, and, like, you'll hear a kind of like a Drew Hill, mm-hmm. how deep is your love kind of riff at the end of the song, which is, like, you know, I wanted to make sure I hit that note. I was just... like, these are the people, like, the groups that inspired me when I was young. I mean, I listened to, like, you know, I've also listened to, like, Backstreet Boys and stuff like that. Don't judge me. You know, I've listened to also songs from other countries. So, Korean music, Japanese music. R&B, that's the thing as we don't realize, as people, R&B travels all over the world. Mm-hmm. Like, when it comes to hip-hop, when it comes to rap, when it comes to all of this, like, we've literally changed the world. We've changed the game. So I'm always, like, surprised how much people don't know this. When I went to Kazakhstan, the first person that I got a taxi drive from, he was playing Tupac. Like, wow. No joke. So to be in another country and to hear, like, how R&B, hip-hop, rap, like, literally, it's like people all over the world are listening to our music. It's like, it's mind-blowing. Mm-hmm. And I just, yeah.
It's the universal language, like they always say, you know?
Exactly. 100%.
I love the song. Our listeners love the song. How can people get in touch with you? I want you to give all your information on how to get, you know, hold of the music video, because the music video is thebomb.com. But everything that is associated with Keith O'Harris.
Okay, awesome. Hey, you'll find me on social media easily. Keith O'Harris on Instagram, Keith O'Harris on YouTube. Definitely go to YouTube, everyone, and check out the music video. Type in She's an Instagram Model, and you will see it there. There's an English version and a Kazakh version, because, again, I'm dabbling in all the languages. Keith O'Harris Facebook, Keith O'Harris Twitter, everything. If you look me up, you'll find me. And then, of course, you can just type in Keith Orlando Harris on IMDb, and then you guys could see, you know, the awards and just some of the stuff I've done. So I'm just so grateful that you've had me on. This is amazing to me. I'm the happiest man in the world right now.
Well, you have such a great spirit. You have such a fun music. But let me tell you this. There are thousands and thousands of people that are listening and will be listening to this, because we always record our interviews so that way we can play them more than one. We get more bang for the buck. That's what I like to call it. So you got all these people that are listening. What advice would you give to the kid or the upcoming artist? They're hearing you and they're saying, I want to do what Keith is doing. I want to be like Keith O'Harris. I want to make films and music videos and live that life. What advice would you give to that aspiring entertainer?
If you have a thought, just try. Like, I've had the thought of doing a song since I was a kid, and I never thought it was possible. And then the moment that I started, you know, surpassing my own expectations, doing filmmaking, you know, starting to win awards, and I saw what was possible, I realized that the only thing you have to have is that thought, that seed. And if you water that seed, it will grow and it will become something beyond your expectations. So just believe in yourself. It doesn't matter where you're from. It doesn't matter what color you are. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter what gender you are. Just, if you have a dream, if you have a thought, give everything to it and never give up till you get there.
I love that. Well said. All right, Keith, I want you to give that information where people can find your art one more time, because I want to make sure that listeners and everybody really gets it. So give that information one more time.
Okay, so again, just Keith O'Harris, K-E-I-T-H-O-H-A-R-R-I-S. Okay, at Keith O'Harris on on Instagram at Keith O'Harris, on YouTube at Keith O'Harris, Twitter, Facebook, everywhere. I think I've gotten it everywhere. Hopefully, I'm not putting this out there, someone doesn't beat me to another Keith O'Harris for whatever's the new thing out there. But yeah, and you'll be able to find my stuff on there. And again, she's an Instagram model. Type it in on YouTube and see the music video. It's awesome.
Wow, wow. Is there any last things that you'd like to comment on?
I just want to thank you because this has been the most amazing experience. Like, I'm so happy right now. And I'd like to thank the listeners for taking the time out to listen to me ramble on as well. So thank you so much.
Wow. All right, Keith. Thank you so much. We got to do this again because this is what we call a fun interview.
Oh, I love it. I'm down. Anytime.
All right. Thank you so much. And you have a good one.
All right,
all right. Bye-bye. Keith O'Harris right here at the KISS Station, KISS 104.7.
Hey, everybody, what's going on? This is Keith Orlando Harris. Check out my new hit song, She's an Instagram Model, only on KISS FM.
Instagram model.